I'm pretty sensitive. I'm a crier. I'm a clean freak. I can't concentrate if there's a mess, ever. What's it like being Amber Valletta?
Being Amber Valletta.
Being Amber Valletta. Being Amber Valletta.
So let's start with the questions.
Hello. Hi, Chris. Amber. Nice to meet you. I was born in Phoenix, Arizona. I grew up in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Hi, y'all. Favorite city in the world?
Stuff.
Paris. I love the fight. The French have a real rebellious side to them, and I love it. Let's see, three words. That's so hard. Self-reflective, sort of two words. Courageous, funny, classic with an edge. There's always something like there. I think the biggest misconception people have of me is that I'm really austere or classic or something because I can photograph very classic, or in films I play these like rich housewives or something, and it's so not me. I'm so the opposite of that. I'm kind of really chill. I'd like to be in anything David Lynch does, something quirky and a little off, so I'm waiting for that. I was 15 when I started modeling. I think probably around 22, I would tell myself to relax and have more fun.
Was there a time when you started to relax and have more fun?
Yeah, when I hit about 40. I mean, the best thing about getting older is you do definitely get wiser and you feel more comfortable in your skin. And then the worst part about it is, like, you know, the body is starting to kind of break down. It goes the other way. So that's hard. I try to do things for exercise that I love, but I also do it for necessity, since it's for my health and for my mental health and my job. I work out with a trainer a few days a week. I spin, I do yoga, I hike. I also do a dance class. I am reading right now a book called Educated, but I just finished a book by Toni Morrison called The Bluest Eye, Jitterbug Perfume, or The Alchemist. My biggest passion in life, besides my family, would be the environment. My mother had really strong values about taking care of your community and the world around you, and we're not in climate change, we're in climate crisis. We have the ability to really change the trajectory of the climate crisis. It's up to us. If you can, buy vintage or repurpose your clothing, change the hemline, try and buy something that's like an heirloom piece rather than buying something that's disposable. Ask questions of the brands you like. You know, what is their sustainable policy? How do they treat their workers in their factories? Don't throw things in the trash. Clothes do not go in the trash. You either have to find a bin where they actually recycle them or donate them.
One of your fellow iconic 90s supermodels, this Canadian model hosted an MTV show with you in the 90s.
Shalom.
Well done. One of the most...
like a buzzer.
One of the most famous Belgian fashion designers, designing one of your more recent iconic looks, the Met Gala 2019.
Anthony Vaccarello.
Correct. Not known for fashion, but more for his rapping and singing, he starred alongside you in a 2005 rom-com.
Hitch. Will Smith.
This Brit was another 90s supermodel, scouted at 14 years old at JFK Airport.
Oh, hey.
That's cool. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
We're done.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I don't know why these questions are making me nervous.